Before we get started, please don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, and hit that bell for notifications. Let's get started. Wait, here. No. You know what? How about we, dang it. Oh gosh. Whoa. Already getting a viewer. Dang, that was quick. Come on. Thank you. YouTube. Give me a second here, I gotta see your comment. Hey Landon, what's up, buddy?
How you doing?
We got gnomes injured. So you know something? I know who we can put in there. I'm like, what kind of running back is he? Whoa. Sweet, Landa. Ajayi just does not seem to work with our offense. Trade Center. He's balanced. Oh, God. Wait a minute. One cut, of course. Balance. Oh shit. I'll probably just be streaming for like as long as I can. Is his speed 87? Like, really? No, not Johnson. That would not be a good idea. Trust me. Like, 88. Long Peterson. Wait. If we can get Zeke, that would be crazy. That would be absolutely insane. And yes, oh, left outside linebacker. God. Dang it. Oh, that's messed up. Shit. A cunt away. Oh my God. It'll go through just for just Zeke. Guess who we just got? Guess who we just got? I hate Rob. I hate his brother too. When I was playing with Dallas and I was rebuilding them, I decided to put Chouteau as starting over Gronk for one game. Well, actually, it was more towards the end of the game. And Chouteau would always celebrate with Gronk every time Chouteau was on the field. He would celebrate with Gronk every time Gronk got a touchdown. Well, Chouteau got a touchdown. And Gronk didn't even congratulate him or anything. So yeah, I hate Gronk. There you go, Clarence. How you doing today? Jesus, Landon.
Landon Markham III.
Is the new coach of the Miami Dolphins? I think for defense, I'm using Pete Carroll's.
Orchard Park, New York. Today we hit week 10, and we've got a good one in store between the Miami Dolphins.
These were god awful. That was a god awful kick. What the hell?
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll probably wish he'd reconsidered here. It will cost him 10 yards as he's down at the 15.
My playbook's cow. What are you talking about?
Here we go. Now Taylor on first down. Shrugs him off. And he's going to be stopped dead in his tracks. At
Damn.
The 17-yard line. Call it a one-yard gain of the play, and it'll make it
safe. He took a little bit to get up.
Now let's take a look here at the Bills' offense.
I know I'm not supposed to be biased, but LeSean McCoy is one of my favorite running backs in the game. Vision, elusiveness, creativity, can take nothing and turn it into something, catches the ball out of the backfield, and runs with that supreme arrogance that running backs have, the best ones in the game.
Yeah, I think so.
And at the end of a run, or drop a shoulder and get extra yardage.
Now the first carry for LeSean McCoy.
Dang.
And he'll lose yardage here. Back to the 15. He'll wind up losing a yard on the
play. Yeah, I think
and
so.
It's going to make it third down and 10.
Good luck trying to get your running game going against Ndamukong Suh. I mean, he is so strong. Just trying to move him, take one guy, two guys, whatever. I wish you a whole lot of luck. He usually converts an offensive running game into rubble.
Now it's Taylor. And he will avoid the contact as he slides to a stop. 4 yards on the pickup.
My name's Tyler Taylor. I can run the side in the rain. I'm playing a little bit. But what are you talking about?
Back from Miami. He punted 4 times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. Landry now on the return. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well,
that was sad.
And it'll be Dolphin football.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32.
I'll fail.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Second down following the run.
Oh, pooey.
Over, over, over. Watch it now, Marty.
They go to Elliott again.
Yeah.
Here to right at the 40-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to the linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon.
What the hell, Zeke?
There's nowhere for him to cut back as he's taken down in the backfield.
Footing's definitely going to be an issue because it's tough to make those quick cuts that you're used to making on a soggy track. In fact, a Hall of Fame runner once told me, cut on your heels in this type of weather. Gives you better balance.
Back to throw here. And he's got his man on the crossing route. That's Landry. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they can do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver.
Fuck! What the hell? Bullshit. Fuck!
You and I both know we're into a whole new realm of football because we're not just looking at tendencies anymore. We're looking at analytics, and I've got to think the analytics on third and one say run the football.
Yes!
Looking left side.
Oh my God, thank you, Price.
20 yards on the pickup there, and the Dolphins have a first down.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in the paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone? And able to push his way forward here.
Damn
for a
man.
Good little game. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and four.
He had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. On the NFL scoreboard, an update from Foxborough. The Patriots, they're out to an early lead. Tevin Coleman, a first quarter touchdown there.
What the fuck?
Back to the 33. It's a loss of two. Now third down.
Cowboys a little bit surprised by what we just saw there because this has been a pretty long drive. And normally you think that wears down a defense. In this case, looked like the offensive line let him down a little bit.
Yeah, allowed the penetration and the ability to stuff him for a loss. Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter begins with the Dolphins in possession of the football. They're on the march, but facing a third down here. They'll look to throw here. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. The Dolphin passing game rolling here. They've got another first down.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. They worked very well there for a first down.
A first down carry by Elliott. And he's able to get this inside.
What the hell, Zeke?
A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down, and as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
All right, sweet, Landon.
Again, it's Elliott. 4 yards on the play, and that leads to the first and goal.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
Ah!
play that time, and it sets I've seen the Muffin Man.
So if I'm an offensive coordinator, there's one thing that I know for sure. This is one of the top five teams in the NFL against the run. So when I look at my playlist, I'm probably thinking about throwing it.
Bullshit. Yes, I traded Ryan Tannehill. He sucks. Man, what the heck was the deal with that? Like, really? I think I traded them to, like, the freaking,
oh, God. Yeah, that's who it was. The 49ers. Yeah, they needed another sucky quarterback. Okay.
Welcome back, everyone. A new era field just south of Buffalo. It's the Dolphins in possession of football as we rejoin the action in quarter number two.
Let's try this again. Zeke, don't you dare drop that ball either.
Damn it, Zeke!
Oh shit.
What the fuck?
He is knocked down from the side. He lost two and it brings up four.
They might think about going for it here, but it's still just the second quarter. Take the 3 points, tell the defense you believe in them, and let them get the ball back for you.
This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on fourth down? And, oh, okay, forget the field goal, because that looked like an easy 3 points.
Zeke doesn't fumble.
The defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
I don't remember if I traded him or not.
Here's Parkey now set to kick it away. Now Tre'Davious White on the return. And he's across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line.
No, we don't.
And now out come the Bills. And still a lot of football to be played in this season. We're only in November. A lot can happen between now and January. But if it ended,
if you couldn't tell, I'm a Dallas fan.
On the outside of the playoff picture looking in, so a lot to fight for.
Yeah, wasn't it interesting in our meeting with the coaching staff? They all made sure to let us know. We know where we are right now. But the players,
and now look at this. Big game, but a fumble.
Oh my fucking God. You got to be kidding me.
And feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable.
Wow.
The friend there.
No doubt about it. Ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession. No turnover. I know his coaches are screaming.
You son of a bitch.
So they jumped on the left side of that line.
And you know, when you're at the end spot, You are like in the starting blocks, waiting for the pistol to fire and go, and he jumped a little bit too early. After the penalty hits McCoy, and he is level. Knocked down hard, right at the line of scrimmage. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. Back to Buffalo after this.
Oh, God. Fine. Tampa 2.
A reminder that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll check in with Larry Ridley in Orlando with highlights and analysis of this first half of play.
And I'm going to check in with a heater.
I'm going to be right there with you, Parker. It's complete to his tight end, Charles Clay.
Fuck off.
Big tight end play for the Buffalo first.
That is oh, my God. What the fuck?
Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down. Here's Taylor to throw.
Bitch.
No escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Raekwon McMillan in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes.
How? How did you?
They'd be starring in the NBA.
How do you just smack it down?
It's a really difficult task.
One thing that like, really, you could have easily caught that.
Here in the first half, they've come after him, they've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing. And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Taylor. And Matthews has it right side. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Damn it.
And he hits the upright, but it caroms in anyway. With plenty of distance there as he banks it in. And
that was bullshit.
But still trailing, it's 7-3.
Are you kidding me?
From the right upright that
what
time.
The hell?
Yeah, I mean, he had more than enough. The only question was keeping it straight. And he's indeed very fortunate to get the bounce there.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. He finds an opening past the 40. Look at the spin. Accelerating and off he goes.
No!
And he is down deep into Buffalo territory. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. As the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. They'll look to throw now on first down. And it's caught. And he's brought down.
No. No. Hey, FaZe, what's up? Bull. That is... Oh, my God. Of course.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Here's Parkey now, set to kick it away.
Okay. Now, hang on.
go.
The Bills offense coming out, ready to take over. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
Now Taylor to throw on second down. Over the middle and caught by the tight end Clay. And on third and inches, we're going to get a whistle and a timeout. As the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half.
Come on, let's go! Now what the fuck,
man? His penalty markers come in. Who is this against? A little antsy on the
really?
Left side of the line.
Yeah, I think they
really?
Got the end. I think they got the DN there on that one. And
McMillan, you are such a dumbass.
Wanting to get a good get off on the snap, jump too quickly.
Throwing now, Taylor on first down. And pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose.
Holy shit. Dion. Oh, they're knocking the hell out of him.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
What the fuck?
He's got the hookup. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's a gain of 13 and a Buffalo first down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
He'll get this one complete to Zay Jones. God!
You son of a bitch!
Big play there in the final seconds of the first half. And the Bills have cut it to within a score.
Terrific. Touchdown. I know we've got a game now.
Every time you go in the second half, down just one or two scores.
What the hell? Dude, what is this?
I think for most teams, when they go into the half in this situation, it's not a lot of adjusting going on. It's much more, all right, guys, let's just play a little bit better than we did the first half.
And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. They'll start the drive with Elliott. And they're able to get this one across.
What the fuck? I pushed Goldham out!
Time here, and it's the visiting Dolphins taking a lead to the locker room. As we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Of course.
And we've seemingly lost communication.
Fuck off,
with Larry.
Larry.
Good news, though. Both teams somehow already back on the field and ready for the third quarter. That's fielded in the end zone.
What the fuck, man? Just spin! Spin! You son of a...
Out comes the Dolphins now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you turned that because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
Let's see if they do just that. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is. To not play too much zone.
Cow.
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game. And you can drop
anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
That got weird.
So minutes of the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. Keep on the ground with Elliott. And an alley to run. certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. The bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to the lead. He wants to continue to do so.
This will be field of 58.
Sit your ass down, bitch. Do you know the muffin, man?
So here's the Bills offense. Now they get ready for their first possession.
He lives on Turdberry Lane.
They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned. Because some teams script to start a match, other teams just go, okay.
See what they have up their sleeve. A fake to McCoy. Now it's Taylor. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. They'll give him a yard on the play, and that's going to...
I know the Muffin Man. Do you know the Muffin Man? He my buddy.
From the gun on third down, it's Taylor. And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes.
Dang.
In there to get him, and that's sack number six for him on the year.
And that's his second sack of the game, but this player...
Defensive player of the year. I mean, of the week.
Coming underneath, you name it. He's a big-time guy you have to block.
And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it close to the goal line at the one-yard line. Out comes the Dolphin offense now as they get set to take over here. If they're going to take it in for another touchdown like they did on their last drive, they're going to have to do it the hard way starting at the one.
And boy, is that a difficult position. Obviously, where they are on the field, they have to be careful with the football. But at the same time, they can't be so careful that they can't run their offense as well. Everyone's got to lock in this situation. No mistakes.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. Again to Elliott. And Ezekiel Elliott gonna take it the distance. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. Past the 20. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott with his third touchdown of the game, number seven on the year. And the Dolphins add on to their lead. And that run massively increased his production in this game, and now he's over 100 yards.
Price just kept running with him like, go, 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 go. I got these guys. Go, go.
Big time jaunt all the way to the end zone.
Now Parkey for the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now.
William, you're a buzzkill. You know that.
Here's Parkey now, set to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take
Hey, Landon.
Here. And on the last go around,
what did you think of that run?
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of
Damn.
And hopefully flip the field.
He just got chucked out of bounds. Dude, that was cool.
Very short.
Partner, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking and those big behemoths start to create space for you up front.
Taylor hit. He lost the
ball.
And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. They go back to Elliott. He's been busy. And maybe
they can stop that play.
But this time they get him behind the line.
Partner, I think there's a lesson there. Some days you're just having a really tough time, and for the defense, today has been that day. But after that play, what do you learn? You can still make plays even when the other guy's having success against you.
The give is to Elliott. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line.
Well, that was a fail.
On the run there, that still leaves him with a difficult 3rd and 8 coming up.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Here we go now.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Throwing right, and that's complete. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Job by him to catch the slant and then navigate and break free.
And receivers love slant routes because it gets the ball in their hands so quickly and oftentimes on the move. And when they're on the move like that, then they get to use their best asset, which is usually their speed.
And their speed sometimes, like this instance, can take him into the end zone. Here's Parkey now set to kick it away.
He's got 88 speed, dude.
On the return, here's White. Oh, what a move.
Someone knocked the hell out of him.
Just past the 30-yard line.
Dude, knock the moo out of him, okay?
The Bills offense now, they get set to head back onto the field. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly
right. That, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
They'll go again to McCoy.
Dang. Oh, my God.
He lost two there, and it's third down.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this,
you're 99 speed.
That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. And that'll set them back 5.
Dang.
The Bills on third down. 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This will be 3rd and 19. The gun, it's Taylor. Roberts with it over the middle. A gain of 4 on the play, and that's going to bring up a 4th down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately.
Back now in Buffalo.
What the
now
hell?
The Dolphins are going to halt the action here. It's a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the 4th quarter.
What is wrong with these guys? Oh my God.
Already slim hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on 4th down.
Dude, that'd be awesome if there was such a speed on here.
Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. Letting one go. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 40.
Dang. Marone. Oh my God. He just passed it straight to him.
And now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
From the pistol, here's Elliott. And some room to maneuver. And he's brought down. Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a 1st down.
You know, that's a play they really don't seem to like.
Here's Elliott. And he'll be taken down at the 33, a pickup of about four. Here to go for the offense on second down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw.
Bullshit. Nope. We are going to go perfect in this game. I got 3 dislikes. I think it's because I'm a Dallas fan.
Welcome back, everyone. The new Arrow Field just shut up to Buffalo. We're in the fourth quarter now with the Dolphins in possession of the football.
I swear to God, Bryce, if you run this all the way. Really? Really?
And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. Given 15 yards on that one, and the Dolphins have a first down. So the offense has a first and 10.
Casey.
They'll set up to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete.
Got it inside the 10 at the 8. 11 more on that one and another first down. They're looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still 9-3 Detroit, as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident
doing that
as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
They're going to look to throw.
He won't go down.
And that'll bring up a second and goal. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
What the fuck?
Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this.
Block, you son of a bitches!
Welcome you back in. I guess not content to get another 3 here late. They'll try to add 6 more as they go on 4th and goal. Now they'll throw here. Out of the gun. advantage continues. It's another touchdown. And for them, this train, it just keeps rolling, doesn't it? Well on their way to yet another victory.
Yeah, it's almost a runaway, isn't it? And you just wonder how anyone could stop this. They got full momentum going, full confidence going. But it's not just their own confidence that is leading them. It's the lack of confidence against their opponents now. Because they see
I don't think I really got anyone this team. So that drives from preseason.
And it ends with a touchdown for the Dolphins. Here's Parkey now.
Like, there wasn't really any good players in preseason.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Back onto the field now comes the Bills' offense. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build.
Just something to build on, get it done, and maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Left side, caught by Matthews. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. A good pick up there, 26 yards. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
He's got it to Matthews, complete. And he gets it down to the 32. 10 yards on the pick up there, and it'll be second down. Now they got to get to the line quickly. Again, it's Taylor. Oh, he's got a little daylight. Finding room to the 20.
Son of a bitch.
By sliding. A good pick up there of 20 yards. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Now Taylor with a draw to McCoy. Nice footwork by McCoy. And able to break one tackle but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in this football game. Side as he's knocked down at the 9-yard line.
Damn.
This is how you shape the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4-for-4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when and told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row, I'm going to stay confident, keep
playing. All right.
There's something wrong with the football.
On third down, Taylor, he dropped it. Couldn't hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
One last shot for Taylor.
What the fuck? Man! Are you kidding me? We only got 4 sacks. What do you mean, how? Holy shit, wait a minute. What? Oh my god. I turned my sliders up to compensate for like the shitty amount of XP and I raised them by 50%. But shit. And then Landry. So he's a 91 overall now. Sweet. Wait, what? Aw, damn it. Next week. Two players. Who else? Oh. Another sped. Oh God.
start every gym. Oh, God. Oh, shit. Dalton Loeber, citing inconsistent week-to-week play. Record holder QB Blake Knoll sets team's single-season completion record with 56 and blowout victory. Even in a loss, Joey McMillan is the more complete back. He's still the number one running back on my board, with Harvey Crumpler number two. Oh, okay. So it's about running backs. I know who we're recruiting. Why? Oh, darn, they're 8. What the? What in the world? Oh my God.
I just now realized what the score actually was. Against the,
we got wings up here.
Alright.
You folding up your clothes?
Yeah.
Oh my God, you actually, did you do laundry?
No, it's laundry from yesterday.
I don't understand that crap either. But you know something? Let's get to the training. Hey, sweet. Thank you. No, not yet. I'll scout him after this game.
Mitchell Trubisky.
I love the discussion this week. You know, we had our weekly phone call to talk about our game coming up, and we had to reflect on the fact that he won the NFC Offensive Player of the Week award last week, yet his team lost. You don't see that very often.
No, I know a lot of people dislike that, but when you look at the numbers across the conference from last week, he was clearly... Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted, thrown back across his body. Picked off by Xavier Howard. Now the return here.
First play!
35-yard line.
Brandon, when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach and talked about how they wanted to begin this game offensively, they talked about their script, didn't they? 10 to 15 plays, the first 10 to 15 they had on their script. Nowhere on the script was there throwing an interception, I have to believe.
And a great spot to start this drive from here.
Ah, crap.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
North of 100 yards, the two scores. And, you know, you got to give a lot of credit to the O-line. We talked a lot about him, but offensive line was good, too.
They're obviously in sync with each other, whether it's zone blocking, power running game, no matter what. He understands how to read them and find the creases that they provide.
This is Elliott, and he'll get about five here as he'll take this down inside the 20-yard line.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. Sets him up first and goal.
Not too many teams will use a first-round pick on a tight end, so you know that when one does, he's got to be pretty darn special.
A small example of why they took him in the first round there. Nice little catch and run to get the good yardage. Now Elliott. And he's going to ball his way down to about the one-yard line. A good pick up there, 7 yards, and it's going to be second and goal now. That's what they wanted out of that first down play. Run it down there. Now they're knocking on the door.
The only thing that would have been better was getting it in. And now they can do whatever they want because they've got confidence on their side. Line up quickly and go. Or savor it a little bit. But I run right back at them.
They'll try again with Elliott. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down.
What the hell, Zeke?
Muster only a yard there, and they'll be left with a third and very short.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Oh, no.
We're going to get a whistle and a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So now third and goal. And he is in. Touchdown, Miami. Ezekiel Elliott hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Dolphins are going to take a first quarter lead. Able to punch it in on third down makes it easier for those guys on the sideline. They didn't have a fourth down decision to make.
Yeah, could you feel the exhale? Because they were already thinking ahead, as all the good coaching staffs do. Anticipating, will we have to make the call? They already had it lined up.
Dang.
Never even got to it.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And for back
you
there, nice move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. The Bears offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And to be frank, they're just in a tough spot. It's only November, already eliminated from playoff contention. I know their fan base doesn't want to hear that, but that's the case. What are they fighting for now going forward?
You know exactly what they're fighting for. It's that word that some people don't want to hear, but it's pride.
Draft. Oh, okay. Yeah. I was going to go draft, but pride's better, right?
You know something? You're right, because that's part of it, but that's two different mindsets. That's front office mindset, yeah. Draft position. Where are we going to be and what do we need to get? And then the players and the coaching staff right now, pride. Can they win some games and feel better about themselves despite the fact they have no shot at the playoffs?
Here's carry number one for Jordan Howard. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down.
Dude, this team is horrible. They're just horrible. Oh my God.
Three times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Now Landry. Oh, leaves him behind on the spin. Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And that will come the offense as they take over. The Dolphins getting set to go here. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great spot to be in, but I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms. Yeah, we know where we'd be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today.
Right.
So they continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number one in their conference.
And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said?
What the hell?
That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football.
Are you kidding me, Price?
When it's in the air,
are you kidding me? How are you?
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold.
You're an ass.
It was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Back to throw now on second and 10. And he comes back with one complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That one goes for 24 yards.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. Dancing to his left. A
yes!
Caught. And they
do stop it, but he takes it all the way to the 2. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
And the
Not in the yard, showing them a good ability to jump to dance outside of the pocket, complete the deep ball.
And don't think for a second that the coaching staff didn't have their heart rate accelerated a little bit there, right? Anytime you have those young quarterbacks.
Yes!
Touchdown, Dolphins! Devontae Adams, his fifth
touchdown
on the year. And the Dolphins are able to grow their lead. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was the super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball in the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are a lot of plays, a lot of options involved with that.
Now the Bears offense ready to take over again. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that zero off the board. Brandon Gordon, Charles Davis back with you as it's Bears football here to begin quarter number two. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out. Movement there on the offensive line, a little quick, and a 5-yard penalty. And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. And they're 6 yards away from picking up the first here on second down. Out of the gun, Trubisky. And he'll
no!
tackle there with a slide. Call it a gain is 7, and it gets him a new set.
Fucking prick.
Take this up to about the 37. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action, hit them over the top.
Looking for an opening, not much there. He'll get it to the 39. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to 3rd down.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. They control the clock, they control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
What the fuck?
And he's going to get this down to the 35.
Whatever.
Gain of 26 on the 3rd down conversion.
Seriously.
So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let him know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. When they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Given 4 on the ground there, they're now left with 3rd and 6.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun, then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. Give him 2 yards on that play, and it'll be 4th down. Now Gostkowski will come on to try a field goal. From the right hash, it's a 46-yard attempt. And this one is right down Broadway. And they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3.
What position does Cameron Wake play again? Yes, I traded him, but it wasn't for picks. Are you kidding me? What the hell?
Oh man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands.
Oh, shut up.
Unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt on offense, if that fell harmlessly to the ground.
What the?
Down sideways.
The 19, 1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up 3rd and 9.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Forcing completion on first down, then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
What the fuck, Gronk? God!
Incomplete.
You son of a bitch!
But you saw the contact, able to jar it free from it.
God!
Great play defense.
Fucking hate you.
Just to knock it free, because if he had caught that, pass the sticks, first down.
Let's go.
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw.
Thank you.
And that's sack number 7 for him on the year.
Dude, you don't need to trade much for fucking Dion.
Turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do and the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Really?
Every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
2 minutes remain here in the first half.
You gotta be fucking kidding me.
To Soldier Field following this short break. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Larry Ridley will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. They'll look to throw here. They're looking deep for Adams.
Bullshit. Nope. Fuck off. This game should seriously be a freaking blowout by now. But no, instead, it's 14-10. Makes plenty of fucking sense. Ryan Shazier is pretty easy to get a hold of, too. You don't need to trade much for him.
Back now on EA Sports at Venerable Soldier Field here in Chicago. It's the Dolphins in possession of the football as we rejoin the action in quarter number two. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. They'll look to throw now on first down. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
What the fuck?
To play here in the first half. We're back to Soldier Field following this short break.
Of course. Why wouldn't he fumble?
A reminder that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll check in with Larry Ridley in Orlando with highlights and analysis of this first half of play.
And I'm going to check in with a heater.
I'm going to be right there with you, partner. And he's got his man on the crossing route. That's Landry. And now running right through it. And he's going to go out of bounds at the 30-yard line.
What position? Yes, I did. I don't remember. I believe I may have traded him for the right end I have now.
That was a nice pickup. Some chunk yardage there. Some of those big yards downfield with a little bit of rack thrown in there. A little run after catch. It came on a crossing route. I can just hear one of my friends who won 4 Super Bowls as a quarterback always said the same thing. What route does a defense hate? Crossing route. Hate it, hate it, hate it, because it's hard to change direction when they get going full speed in the other way.
Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket. Got to the sticks and
missed
the first down.
And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. Another nice gain. 16 yards there and a first down again. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
Takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver.
What the fuck? Oh my God.
Where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone. Sometimes you're throwing it between the zones. Sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when it
yes
into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott with touchdown number 2 in the game and now 11 on the year. And the Dolphins add on to their lead. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts.